that you make for yourself. I was gifted my first puppet by my mother, and I became hooked to puppet theater. As someone once mentioned, a childhood hobby that went out of control. I am the founder of the Katkatha Puppet Arts Trust. Currently, I work as the managing trustee and the artistic director. Puppet theater is the theater of material, and it's very important to understand this material that we are working with. Puppets have an incredible ability to move people, because essentially people are just projecting onto the puppet. And I always think of it as our work because I've never worked alone. It's always been Katkatha, which has always been a core team of puppet builders, puppeteers and musicians and scriptwriters. So it's always a few people thinking together. I think the key element in this work is friendship. And this is probably true for all theatre forms, but the kind of puppet theatre we do, sometimes with three people moving one puppet, I think this intimacy and this intimate knowledge of each other is extremely important. Puppet can't live because of a puppeteer. The puppeteer only moves the puppet. And the puppet is material that is moving, but it lives inside the audience's head. It lives in the imagination of the viewer. That's the only place it will live. The rest of the time, it's dead. Yes, the arts community is going through a very difficult time. And here I'm going to stress on the puppet theatre community, because that's a very small community. It's a fringe art form. It also has the extremely marginalized single performer who's also a farmer, does this seasonally. Very much like folk theatre in that sense. Those who are farmers and had agricultural practices are slightly better off because they didn't have a food shortage. But, you know, the Katputli Walas, for instance, they are neither landed. They don't have a village agrarian context anymore. They've moved to the cities. Most often, they have settled in urban slums. They've been very, very hard hit. There was a massive food crisis right after the lockdown happened. The community pooled in a lot of resources to raise money to actually just feed people. Because I think we also acknowledge our vulnerability and the fact that we could disappear as an art form at any point. I must say what has been very heartening is how people have come together. It was really, really heartening to see.